In Destiny, you can go to a number of different bodies in our solar system. Earth, the Moon, Venus, and Mars. So how do they compare to their real-life counterparts? Okay, so starting out, the average height of an Australian woman is about 1.75 meters, while Australian man is about 1.85 meters. So starting with the only habitable place in the solar system, Earth, I enlisted the help of two Australian friends, Bex and Sneaky. So utilizing the height of a person in Destiny, you can jump about 2.25 meters, which is about 7.5 feet, and it takes about 6/10 of a second to drop back down to Earth. This brings the local gravity to about 12.5 meters per second squared, which is about 27% higher than the actual gravity. Considering the gravity for every planet in Destiny is this exact same, it's about 7.5 times stronger on the Moon, 3.5 times stronger on Mars, and in fact, on the Moon, your character should actually be able to jump about 6 times higher. Speaking of moons, Mars has two, Phobos and Deimos, which I'm totally saying wrong. Phobos is so small in real life that a 150 pound human would only weigh about 2 ounces. Moving on to Venus, it appears they completely omitted its moon. This makes total sense because Venus doesn't actually have a moon. But what doesn't make total sense is why you're actually even able to walk on Venus. Due to the dense cloud cover on the surface, the pressure is about 93 times higher than that of Earth, which is equivalent to being about 930 meters below the ocean surface. With this combination of temperature and pressure, CO2 could actually be in a liquid state, which is pretty concerning since I've been sitting in this puddle for quite some time. On the Moon, you could see Earth innocently spinning in the distance. It's so close though, you could basically see your house from here, and a destroyed space station appears to be completely stationary about 200 feet from the surface. If you want to know more about why this can't happen, go check out my video about Halo. So anyways, Destiny is just a game, and there are legitimate reasons to normalize things like gravity or neglect pressures and temperatures, and let's be honest, the Earth looks pretty awesome from here. Anyways, guys, if you enjoyed the video, give it a like. If you want to see more, subscribe. And thanks for watching.